Come stai?
Congratulazioni.
Congratulazioni anche a te.
Congratulations to you, sir.
Bertrand Battani, I'm the French advisor to the Prime Minister.
Nice to see you, sir.
To see you. Hi, how are you? Well, come in.
Our conversation will be limited for a while because it's been three waves.
Sì, sì, è vero.
Well, this is your third visit.
Sì. No, questa è la quarta.
Actually, it's the fourth.
Where have I miscounted?
Qualcuno ha sbagliato il conto.
Sì, qualcuno ha sbagliato il conto. Io sono venuto l'83, l'84, l'86 e adesso.
Mr. President, Senator Baker said he'd be the one to turn out the lights here at the White House. Does that mean the lights are out on your administration?
No, that means I think a little change has occurred.
Did you see the trade figures this morning, Mr. President? It's one of the best trade reports in some time. Something like under $10 billion for the monthly report. Do you have a comment on that?
Yes, sir. It'd be a happy comment because it shows that we have continued to bring down the trade deficit. It has been on a pretty continual decline. And it's been brought about this time by not only an increase in exports, but a decrease in imports.
Could we clarify your position, Mr. President, on the business of plant closing? Would you support a move in Congress toward a voluntary provision of plant closing? That would not be mandatory.
Yeah, we already have that, and we have a number of plants that have relations with their unions, that in their union labor contract have provisions for that. It is just that I believe that excessive controls and regulations by government, we've seen comparison with some of our trading partners that have too much of that. And they've not been able to match our economic expansion.
Will you seek more military aid for the conference, Mr. President, or is that a lost cause?
Well, this is something that's under discussion right now.
Are you going to miss Howard Baker?
What?
Are you going to miss Howard Baker?
Yes,
What kind of job has he done, Mr. President?
He's done a fine job. Both as leader of the Senate, and now as he came over here.
Senate, I knew I was.
We've got to go, we've got to.
This way, cameras, please.
Mrs. Picture taking? Mrs. Picture taking?
This way.
He's quite a photographer.
Come on.
Let's go, please.
Come on.
All of this. Fondamentalmente per motivi personali.
Minister, if I may, I'd like to begin this session by giving you a few of my impressions of the summit meetings with Gorbachev. I came away from Moscow believing that U.S.-Soviet relations are in better shape now than at any time in the past decade, perhaps in the entire post-war period. I think it's clear that Gorbachev wants to reform the Soviet economy, but it'll take him a long time if he succeeds at all. He's also making political changes, though their extent is less clear. And he, of course, there's no question he has some opposition within his own government to what he's trying to accomplish. So that I think that, meanwhile, even in our hopeful optimism, I think we have to consider that the Soviet Union will remain a potentially dangerous adversary abroad in a controlled society at home until we have more evidence of what he intends and what his success is. I also think the Moscow summit, though, added an important building block in establishing ways to solve our problems with the Soviet Union. We'll continue talking to the Soviets on regional issues, arms reduction, human rights, and bilateral exchanges during the rest of this year and into 1989 and hopefully beyond. One more general point. I was impressed by Moscow and impressed by the people I met. I met with students at their university, religious leaders, and a group of refuseniks and dissidents, and then with they have a writers association, and they put together a meeting with not only fellow writers, but with artists and people from the theater and so forth. And beyond that, we had opportunity for some informal meetings just with people on the street. And that was the biggest surprise of all. The absolute sincere friendship with which we were greeted by the Russian people. I wasn't quite prepared for that in view of the propaganda they've been subjected to for so many years, but it was really, it was a real warm enthusiasm on their part. I think we struck some important blows for human rights in our meetings. And quoting Solzhenitsyn in Moscow was kind of a milestone with regard to my public remarks. But we'll continue to press particularly on the human events. On arms reductions, we made some solid progress on what we call the START Treaty. That's the 50% reduction. And we tabled our positions on mobile missile verification and air-launched cruise missiles. And on the whole, the Soviet response was positive. There are important issues remaining, and we'll keep plugging away at them. In defense and space, sharper differences remain. The Soviets are still trying to cripple or get us to give up on our strategic defense initiative, and they have not yet agreed to correct their treaty violations of the ABM treaty. So I think, having said all that, I should defer to you now. You might have something on your agenda you would like to bring up, or any questions you might have.
Io voglio innanzitutto dire quello di Toronto. La nostra valutazione che il grado delle relazioni tra est e ovest condizionerà.
Thank you.
There are now 10,000 in Red Square. And still didn't disturb him. He said, the more the merrier. Finally, they're back in, and they said, there are now 50,000 people in Red Square. And he said, well, what are they doing? And they said, they're eating. Well, he said, what's wrong with that? He said, they're eating with chopsticks.
Laugh.